talk to any first responder, and within the first minute, they'll all say the same thing. Dealing with a highway incident is the most dangerous thing we do. It's not just car fires, it's accidents, it's people going in the ditch on an icy day like today. It's that distracted driver coming at them at 75, 80 miles an hour, driving right into those blue lights. They don't know if they're gonna get over or slam on their brakes or plow right into them. When you go to a show, it's amazing the number of people, whether it's a fire captain, a firefighter, a DOT dump truck driver, or a DOT supervisor, the number of people that have been hit, and the number of people that have been hit with a trailer attenuator behind them. One guy this past spring, his trailer was hit by a minivan going 70 miles an hour. He was stopped, the host vehicle driver. He said he barely felt the impact. They're using this as a protection device for that million-plus-dollar ladder truck that they might otherwise park at an angle across the freeway. That thing's a sitting duck. You know, if that gets hit, it's a year, 2 years to get that thing replaced, just from a manufacturer perspective, and they save lives.
And the first responders, for sure, and particularly the rescue vehicles that are sitting out there, they're in the middle of it all. They have to be as close to the scene as they can. And when you've got an interstate where traffic's going at 30 miles an hour, and now it's shut down to a crawl, but you know, then all of a sudden they have a lull in traffic, they're speeding by again. And so, I know if I was a first responder, I'd sure like to have that behind me.
We deploy our attenuators, at least one of them, on any traffic incident or any emergency call on our interstate system. In previous years, we've seen several law enforcement vehicles as well as law enforcement officers struck by vehicles, especially times of inclement weather, whether it be rain, snow, ice, things like that. And so we wanted to take a proactive approach on how to protect the responders, number one, and then number two, also our apparatus that are more expensive when sitting on roadways, especially high speed, working those incidents.
And when that call comes in, it's the first apparatus that leaves the station. Ambulances can request it, state troopers can request it if they want that additional protection from the drivers.